In 6 chapters, there is a glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. And in that chapter, after hearing the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam, Narada Muni, he inquires from the four Kumaras, "Oh, four Kumaras, do you have a history of someone who got delivered from hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? Okay, we know Parikshit, but is there any other person?" So, four Kumaras started narrating a history. There was a Brahmana, his name was Atmadev. This is from Padma Purana. And this Atmadev Brahman, he had everything in his life. He had a wealth, he had a beautiful wife, he had all the opulences, but there was one problem with him. He had no children. And because of that, he was always lamenting, he was always crying in his heart of the hearts that my life is useless if I don't have kids. So with this, he tried all the means. He tried all the means to help all the pujas, all the vidhis, all the karmakand he did to help to have a child, but it was not possible. So this Atmadeva Brahman, being frustrated with his life, he decides that let me go and give up my life. So he goes to the forest with the intention of finishing his life. But there he meets a sannyasi, and as soon as he sees that sannyasi, he sees that he is a very powerful sannyasi. So he offers his dandavats to him and he begs and he keeps his problem in front of that sadhu. And the sannyasi says, "It's good that you don't have kids. Having kids is a problem. See from the life of Chitraketu Maharaj. He tried to change his destiny. He got a kid from the blessing of the sadhu, but then his life again became very miserable." So in this way the sadhu was instructing him. But he said, the Brahmana said, "Oh sannyasi mahashay, you don't know the glories of grahastha ashram. There is no spice without children in grahastha ashram. Please bless me that I can have children." So sannyasi looked at him very carefully and said, "I can see, forget about this birth, for the next 7 births, you won't have a child, you won't have a kid." He said, "What? For next 7 births?" Then the Atmadeva Brahman, he thought to himself, "Wow, if this sannyasi can see my 7 births, then he is qualified to give me a son in this birth also." So he jumped and he caught hold of the lotus foot of the sannyasi and said, "Please, please give me a son, please, you can give me a son, please." He said, okay. He took a fruit from it, the sannyasi took a fruit from that tree. He prayed to Krishna and he gave it to him. And he said, "This will give you pleasure and also misery in this life." He said, Will I get a son?" He said, "Yes, you will get a son, but you will get misery and destroys and everything in this life." He said, "No problem. That is okay. That is a part of the life." So Atmadeva Brahman, he went back, he gave that fruit to his dear wife. But if his wife was very good, she was not unchaste, but she had no interest in giving birth to a baby. And now here was a fruit, and she knew that this fruit is certainly going to bear her a child. So she called up, she discussed this thing with her sister, and the agreement was that she will not eat this fruit. Instead, they gave that fruit to the cow who was there in their family. The cow was there. They gave the fruit to the cow, and the agreement was that the sister will provide her child to that wife of the Atmadeva Brahman. But this was all done without the notice of Atmadeva Brahman. So Atmadeva Brahman, he was a simple man, so he thought that his wife might have eaten the apple or the fruit which was given, but this didn't happen. So all this plan of the wife and his sister was kept secret, and gradually the days passed, and the sister gave birth to a baby boy, and it was brought to Atmadeva's wife, and it was broadcasted that Atmadeva's wife gave birth to a baby boy. Certainly there were so many things were there that the wife was away from the husband from 1 year completely. She was just to keep herself away from the problems so that the husband shall not know the secret. So she was keeping away from the husband. So all these things were there. So this one has to understand. So gradually this boy, he was named as Dhundukari. And after a few months, a cow gave birth to another boy. By the mercy of that sadhu's fruit, the cow gave birth to a boy, and this was named Gokarna. The people in the villages started saying, look at the fortune of Atmadeva Brahman. There was a time when there was no children in his house. Now even the cow is giving the children here. The cow is giving birth to a boy. Look at the fortune of Atmadeva Brahman. But there was a huge difference between these two boys. Gokarna was blessed by, was taken birth by the mercy of a sadhu. She was naturally inclined towards Krishna consciousness. Whereas the son, Atmadeva's son, which was actually the son of the wife's sister, he became a very mischievous boy. He was a troublemaker. Right from his young age, he used to kill people, he used to beat up people, he used to murder, he used to plunder, he used to do all kinds of nonsense. Gradually, Gokarna grew, becoming a great devotee of the Lord, and he never stayed in his house because he knew there was always fight because of Dhundukari. So he traveled preaching everywhere. At the same time, Dhundukari, he became very, very mischievous, and gradually he married 5 prostitutes. And to please those 5 prostitutes, Dhundukari, he used to earn money by all the wrong means, and he used to please and satisfy these prostitutes. So one fine day, the prostitutes, they had a meeting, and they discussed among themselves that if the king finds out that our husband is the money which our husband has is not earned by the righteous way, then the government will take away all the money. So why not we ourselves kill our husband and divide all the money, divide all the money amongst ourselves and go. But what they discussed, what should we do with this husband? They said, let's kill him. So all the 5 prostitutes, they killed Dhundukari and buried him in that very house of his. And they all took the money and gradually they left. Somehow, the villagers, the people in the village, they found out gradually the situation with Dhundukari, that he was killed. So a message was sent to Gokarna. Gokarna was always on the pilgrimage, but a messenger was sent to Gokarna that your brother has died in this way. Gokarna was amazed and he was saying, what can be done? So he knew the glories of Gaya in the scriptures. So he went straight to Gaya and he offered the Shraddha ceremony, the Pindadan he did for Dhundukari. And after doing all this, all the Shraddha ceremony, Gokarna, he came back to his village to find more about his brother. And he stayed in the same very house where he was, that the body of Dhundukari was buried. When Gokarna came, this Dhundukari had already gotten the ghostly form, and he was staying in that house. And as soon as Gokarna came there, Dhundukari manifested himself in a ferocious form, and he was trying to speak something to Gokarna. But Gokarna saw that inability of that ghost. So Gokarna was carrying the Ganges water with him. So he simply sprinkled the Ganges water, and by the grace of the Ganges, Dhundukari got the strength to speak. So Dhundukari, he said to his dear brother, he said, my dear brother, I am in this terrible situation, I am your brother. Please, please help me to come out of this ghostly form of life. And Gokarna said, what? I performed Shraddha ceremony for you in Gaya and you still not delivered. The Gaya is a very glorious place. Anyone who performs Shraddha there, however situation he might be, he will get a human form of life at least. But I am very sad to see that you are in this situation. Now what can be done? He said, my dear brother Gokarna, please help me. He said, okay, we will try to figure out a solution. Next day, Gokarna invites all the scholars from that village and also the nearby village to find out from the scriptures what is the solution for this Dundukari. So they all went through their scriptures. Everybody went through the scriptures and they all, in that big assembly, they concluded that if but sacrifice in Gaya cannot deliver Dundukari, then there is no hope of his deliverance. But they all finally gave a solution to Gokarna and said that if you can ask the sun god, who is the witnesser of all the activities, if you can ask him, he can certainly give you a solution. And Gokarna was qualified enough. So hearing the brahmanas advised, Gokarna stopped the movement of sun god and requested, oh sun god, I have a question for you. Please guide me, please help me. You know the situation of Dundukari. I wish to seek your help for a solution. How can my brother be delivered? And the sun god said, oh Gokarna, oh great devotee of the Lord, please recite the Srimad Bhagavatam which was spoken by Shukadeva Goswami to Maharaj Parikshit. If Dundukari hears this Srimad Bhagavatam, he will be delivered from the cycle of birth and death and he will be elevated to become an associate of the Supreme Lord. So simply recite the Srimad Bhagavatam. So a big ceremony was arranged and Gokarna appointed a Vaishnava to ask questions on everybody's behalf. And Gokarna, he started reciting Janmadiya Sayatanvayadi Tarata Sharte Shubhigya Swarat Tene Brahmaridayadi Kavaye Muyanti Yatsuraya Tejo Vari Mridam Yathavini Mayo Yatratri Sargomrusha Dhamna Svena Sadani Rasta Kuhakam Satyam Param Dhimahi. So in this way, Gokarna recited the entire Srimad Bhagavatam. And Dundukari, an arrangement was made for Dundukari. There was Dundukari had an airy body. So a bamboo was kept, which had 7 knots in it. And Dundukari was sitting inside that airy body and he was hearing with rapt attention the Srimad Bhagavatam which was spoken by his brother Gokarna. And each evening, this Bhagavatam was going on for day and night. Don't think that this Bhagavatam was a 1 hour class. Certainly not. It was a day and night affair. And every day in the evening, the one knot in that bamboo used to burst. And gradually, each day, one knot used to burst. Second day, second knot. Third day, third knot. Fourth day, fourth knot. Fifth day, fifth, sixth. Seventh day, the bamboo was bursted and Dundukari, he appeared in front of everyone in four-armed form of the associate of the Lord of Vaikuntha. He was, by the mercy of Srimad Bhagavatam, by the mercy of Gokarna, he was transformed into an associate of the Lord. And after Gokarna was transformed, Dundukari was transformed like this, he folded his hands and he glorified Srimad Bhagavatam. Now what did he say to Gokarna and everyone will like to hear that. He said, oh my dear brother, by your mercy I have been released from the ghostly body. This ceremony of discussing Srimad Bhagavatam is so glorious that it will destroy the ghostly forms and it will elevate one to become an associate of the Supreme Lord. This is the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then he says, Dundukari was a ghost, but now in a form of a forearm form of the Lord of associate of Vaikuntha. He's saying, when a person starts hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, the sins which are accumulated in his life for so many millions of years, they tremble in fear, anticipating that this Bhagavat Katha will destroy them completely, like a fire destroys or uproots, or completely destroys the grass roots. Similarly, in the same way, the Srimad Bhagavatam burns away all the big sins, all the small sins of a person who takes shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. Scholars, Dundukari is saying, the scholars in the assembly of demigods, they say that people who do not hear Srimad Bhagavatam, their life is an utter waste. What is the value of this temporary life? What is the value of this life by making it strong and stout if one does not hear Srimad Bhagavatam? Now, we have to understand the situation of our body. This body is supported by bones, which are like pillars. Just like these pillars are supporting this construction, similarly, the bones are like the pillars in our body. And they are tied together with the rope of nerves and veins. And it is covered by skin. What is inside? Bones is there. Bones are tied up by nerves and veins. And it is covered by skin. And what is there inside? Flesh. What is there inside? Flesh. And every part of this, our body reeks. And inside, it's only nothing but a pot of stool and urine. This is what Dundukari is saying. And in the old age, what happens that this body becomes a cause of lamentation and misery. Devotees who are old here, you can ask them, what is the situation with their body? And they will say, yes, it is full of problems. Every moment, we get troubled by this body. This body has only three destinations. Only three. When it is buried in the ground, it is eaten by the worms. When it is thrown out, it is eaten by the vultures. And when it is burned, it turns into ashes. These are the only three destinations of this, our so-called body, divine body, which we are very attached to. Food, which is cooked in the morning, it gets rotten by the evening, at least by Indian culture. We understand that food which is cooked in the morning gets rotten by evening. So how can this body be considered eternal since it is nourished by that same ingredients which gets rotten in the evening? So how can we imagine that this body will be permanent? In this material world, people can very quickly attain the lotus feet of the Lord simply by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. This is the only means by which one can completely eradicate the defects of this human form of life. And there are three things which happens when one hears Srimad Bhagavatam. There are three miracles. First, the doubts are removed. Second, the karma is slackened. And third, one becomes relieved from the knots in the heart. The scholars, Dundukari is saying that the scholars say that when Srimad Bhagavatam becomes fixed in the heart, liberation is guaranteed. When Srimad Bhagavatam is fixed in the heart, liberation is guaranteed. So this is the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam.